There is no one element that truly makes a great game. Great games aren't just an amazing score, it's not just great graphics, it isn't just great gameplay, it's everything. Everything has to be perfect if you really want to make one of those memorable experiences. This isn't to say that every element needs to be mind-blowingly awesome. It doesn't have to be the best graphics, but what it has to do is operate within all of the other elements of the game to make it a cohesive creation. Drone Swarm did so many things exceptionally well that it pained me to find a few shaky elements in its gameplay that are going to hold it back from being one of those memorable, long-lasting, exceptional games. But let's start with its exceptional first. Drone Swarm is a technical marvel. Here, you control a spaceship that has 32,000 drones in a swarm that cluster around your ship. Those drones can then be controlled to attack and defend in various ways as you mitigate the onslaught from incoming ships. It's important to note here that each one of these 32,000 ships is independent. It's independently drawn within the game, and it operates independent of all of the other drones. These drones do move in unison, but they are all independent, so when the player asks for an attack or a defense, a number of drones at the same time will come out and do that action, but they are all drawn separately and they all do move separately from each other. Just the fact that this can even possibly work is a technical marvel within an indie game. There's something almost soothing about the motion of all these individual ships flying around, just waiting for your beck and call to tell them what to do. But the impressive elements of Drone Swarm don't end with its technical merits. Drone Swarm is also a beautiful game through and through, and I'm talking about the design of the ships, the design of the explosions and the weapons, but also just the elements in the background, the huge planets and huge spaceships and bases that you're fighting around through the entire game. Everything is intricately drawn and intricately modeled, and it really ties the whole thing together that you are in space, and space is a very, very big place. The story is also a cut above your average indie game. There may be a higher expectation for a sci-fi game, but Drone Swarm doesn't disappoint here. This game takes place in space, where Earth is a dying planet, and you are floating through space, scanning different planetary systems, looking for a replacement home. Along the way, you find other sentient beings that want to attack you for various reasons and stand in your way. I don't want to reveal too much, but there is a lot of twists and turns from what I've seen so far, and the story was one of those elements that really grabbed me from this game and actually held my hand through some of my rougher parts of the game and kept me playing the game even though I wasn't having as much fun as I could with the gameplay mechanics alone. You would expect by having 32,000 drones that is 32,000 opportunities to make a really strategic and well-thought-out game. And Drone Swarm actually pitches it as a very strategic-heavy game. The problem that I found is that the execution of strategy is just not that thick here. This may be an issue of setting unnecessarily high expectations for strategy, but I found Drone Swarm to be more of a reflexive and action-y game than it was a strategy game. In Drone Swarm, you're given three primary attacks, and while they do change and they are modified over time, the three attacks are just to attack an oncoming ship, create a wall so that you can either trap the enemy ships or protect your own ships from fire, and then you have a kinetic ability, which in the beginning of the game starts out as just being able to build swarm up and then fire asteroids at ships, but then later on allows you to push and manipulate things a little bit better. Now, each one of these three does change, like I just mentioned the kinetic one does, but at the core, these three mechanics are just those three things: attack, defend, and a kinetic ability. The first issue I had with these three is a system that they had set up in the game where you build a skill bar up and earn upgrade points. immediately when I saw these upgrade points, my thought was that I'd be able to upgrade statistics for my ship. Fire better lasers, have more drones, drones get stronger. Unfortunately, none of that was true. None of that was available. In fact, rather than upgrading your ship directly, it was for upgrading into new abilities. But then the issue that I ran into with upgrading those new abilities was I gained points at such a rate that I could always afford any new ability right when it became available. So the points were almost pointless in and of themselves because you always had more points than you did abilities that were available to you, so you might as well just unlock the abilities right when you first got them anyways. While this one issue wasn't that big of a deal, it was very confusing to me because I kept looking for some menu that I was not seeing, as I have 3 or 4 points that look like they need to be spent and absolutely nothing to spend them on. This element was much less negative and more just mystifying and curious to me as to why it was implemented this way. Outside those upgrades though, because you only have 3 main attack moves, it really limits the amount of strategy you can actually do. You're able to, with walls, trap your enemies, and you can also protect yourself, so there are a couple options there. But for most fights, I found that the exact same 3 strategies were used over and over and over. For a game that touts itself as being a strategy game, I really would have liked to see a lot more depth in the amount of actions that a player can take, and a lot of the variability in the enemies, so that the game can feel like it's more ad hoc strategy, rather than repeating the same thing from one fight to the next. And this brings me to an issue I had with the enemy ships. Now, there are a pretty good variety among the enemies. Some of them do different things like disabling your swarm, or attacking you, or just making you more weak. The problem I ran into, though, is that the ships don't look different enough from one ship to the next. So, while the game did a good job of pointing out to you, here's a new type of ship, and this is what it's going to do, by the time that introduction was over and that ship came back into the next fight, I couldn't remember exactly what that ship did, so it didn't change my strategy as a player. When I saw the ship, I just continued to do the same wall and shoot mechanics that I had been doing over and over again. There needed to be a lot more visual cues on the enemy ships so that I would see a ship and recognize what it was supposed to do, and I would be able to respond better in a more strategic way. My final criticism for Drone Swarm is regarding the difficulty settings. Here you have an easy, medium, and hard mode, with the easy mode named something along the lines of storytelling, where you're just there to experience the story. Now, I played most of my review play here on the medium mode because I wanted to see what the average player is going to get. Here, it isn't too difficult, and I was able to see quite a bit of success. There were some frustrating moments where I had to play a certain level 3 or 4 times over, but I didn't have too many problems. At one point, though, I really wanted to just see more of the story to really see what was behind what was going on, and I changed it down to the storytelling mode. Unfortunately, I didn't see a very large difference, and I was still losing quite a few levels by playing the storytelling mode, which makes me think that either I was doing something wrong, or there just isn't enough of a difference between the 3 different modes, particularly for a mode called storytelling. This shouldn't be an issue for most players. In fact, most people are going to want to play on the medium and hard mode, but for players that really just want to see that story mode, I really would like to see that easy mode made even easier so people can just see what's going on in this really great universe that they've built. So what are my final thoughts for Drone Swarm? Well, I have a really interesting comment, I think, to say about this game, and that's that I really think that this needs to be a mobile game. Now, this game has a problem, a very businessy problem, and that's that the gameplay here would be a phenomenal tablet game. This on an iPad would be so great, because the way that you draw the lines for the attack patterns and draw the lines for the walls and such, it feels like it wants to be on a tablet and feels like it would be right at home. In fact, it's probably more awkward to be played on a PC than a tablet. The problem that I see with that, though, is that the market for people that are going to want to buy a game like that on mobile, particularly on Android, if this game were on Android, you'd be hard-pressed to get people to pay $10 or $15 for an app and sell quite a few units. But then the problem on PC, however, is that the execution is not quite as great here. It's either going to be a lackluster PC game or it's going to be a really excellent mobile game. And for that reason, I think you end up with this very businessy problem where they're going to have a difficult time monetizing this game. My feeling on PC, though, is that this game is not going to be for everyone. If you're a big sci-fi fan and you like a decent story, this one's going to be for you. This one has a pretty good story, and the gameplay overall is not too bad. But I really wish I could have seen more out of the strategy elements in this game. I just wanted more of what it was, and I think that had there been more strategy elements, more things that you could do with your drones, maybe this would have been one of those really great games. If you liked this video, then make sure to like this video. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, then go take a look at some of my other videos that I have, and if you like those videos, well, then consider subscribing. Thanks for hanging out with me, and until next time, this has been Pixel.